Just because you want a cheap car that'll last doesn't mean that you should throw performance and style out the window. There are plenty of great cars that you can get for under $4,000. And most of the cars on this list are actually a lot cheaper than that. The cars on this list are fun and affordable. But most importantly, they will not break down on you even when they're hit with like a nuclear warhead. So if you're looking for that car that'll last forever, we got you with this list of 8 cheap cars that will never break down on you. Now the first car on this list is like a doomsday bunker on wheels that's got such a plush interior, you'll be riding out the apocalypse in comfort and style. And speaking of comfort and style, check out this shirt. It's ideal. Go pick it up. Over here, there's probably a little shirt flopping around in the corner. Buy it, please, my job depends on it. Now, back to the luxury car that'll outlast you, the Lexus ES300. If you're looking for a ride that'll last a lifetime, but you only have about 2,000 bucks, I bet you weren't thinking Lexus. You definitely weren't thinking of sitting in leather luxury. But luckily for you, the Lexus ES300 is the indestructible Toyota Camry wrapped in Lexus amenities. So why spend money on the Toyota when you could be getting the Lexus? Now, going 0 to 60 in 7 seconds, you're not going to be running anybody off the road in an ES300. But if durability, comfort, and a quiet ride are top of the list for you, then this is the car for you. And because this is a Lexus, it is dead quiet inside and out.
The Lexus ES300 provides a haven of peace and quiet for even the most sensitive ears.
You'll hardly hear a thing as you rack up miles on the highway. And speaking of racking up miles, the ES300 gets a respectable gas mileage of about 20 miles per gallon. But the bad news is, it is a Lexus, so it does require premium fuel. But luckily, the V6 in it is so reliable, the extra money you saved on gas won't really matter because you saved a fortune on keeping this thing running. And like I said before, this reliable luxury roller is cheap, like insanely cheap. We found a clean titled ES with only 100,000 miles on the clock for just $2,000. That's leather, power, and an L on the grill? That is an ideal deal. Now, it is a Lexus, so it might cost a little to keep running. What's another car that'll last forever, but is made to run on a government paycheck? That's right, we're talking the Ford Crown Vic. We all know that replacing anything on a Ford costs about as much as the loose change you have in your pocket. Now, I'm a millennial, so I don't actually have change in my pocket. I don't believe in money, and cash, and coins, and pennies. Who needs all that? So I guess the loose change in your Venmo account? Either way, the Ford Crown Vic is built to be a workhorse. They were used for cop cars, limos, and taxi cabs for a really good reason. These bad boys regularly pass that 300,000 mile mark on pretty much no maintenance. And that's all thanks to that Ford modular V8 that can run until pretty much the end of all time. And bonus, it's a V8 powered rear wheel drive car, so you can have a little fun in there too. And for the best bang for your buck, look out for a police interceptor model. And make sure you don't tell your friends and just pull them over on the street and see what they say. And with all the money you save, make sure you also get yourself a cop uniform. Just kidding, don't do that. That's very illegal to impersonate the police. Don't do that, but it's funny. But also know, if you're buying a police vehicle or even a taxi cab, this car's gonna have a ton of what is called idle hours. You see, it might have relatively low miles, but the engine has been running while sitting in a parking spot for hours, days, months even. Now, if you wanna buy a police interceptor and pretend like you're in the movie Hot Fuzz, you can pick up a pair of aviator sunglasses and get yourself a Crown Vic for well under 2,000 bucks. Now, about the only car as prolific as a cop car is the Honda Accord. You can't go anywhere without seeing 3 or 4 of them on the road, and that's for a good reason. These are like the peanut butter and jelly of durable sedans. Sure, it's no filet mignon, but it's tried and true, and will always get you where you need to go. This is by far one of the newest cars that's gonna be on this list, and is one of the sportiest too. The 2.4-liter four-cylinder in this cranks out 160 horsepower, which doesn't sound like a lot, but we're talking about cars that drive forever, so underpowered is kind of the name of the game here. The best part about the Accord is the fuel economy, which is about 35 miles per gallon. So not only does this save you money when you buy it, it saves you money when you own it too. The Accord is basically good at everything. Honda even rolled out a hybrid model in 2005, but buyers didn't really see the point because the fuel economy in the base Accord is already so good it didn't really justify the price. So if you're looking for an Accord, just go with the standard one, no need to spend money on the hybrid. If you just change the oil and treat it with care, these Japanese juggernauts will last last you well over 300,000 miles. And no one will believe you spent just $3,000 to get the keys to this 2005 Honda Accord that looks like $1 million. Now the Accord is a great people mover, but if you need a stuff mover that'll outlast anything, then probably the most obvious choice is the Toyota Hilux pickup. If you need a pickup truck for your landscaping business or hauling construction materials, or even just cruising around the countryside, you, my friend, definitely need a Toyota pickup. And that's right, this is just called the Toyota pickup, which is an incredible name. It's like if Tesla called their new car the Tesla car. Now the Toyota pickup is the Nokia cell phone of trucks. That's right, it's pretty much completely indestructible. Now the Toyota pickup's other name is Hilux, which is a combination of high and luxury. Although I wouldn't say luxury is exactly this pickup truck's forte. But if you're looking for an inexpensive and reliable pickup truck that can be put to work, the Toyota is even capable of hauling 2,200 pounds with an engine that you will be passing down to your grandkids. This is a dated joke. You guys ready for some old jokes? They say there are three things that will outlive the apocalypse: cockroaches, Chuck Norris, and the Toyota pickup. You guys remember Chuck Norris? Remember when that was like a thing? Capable, reliable, versatile, and most importantly, cheap. This is exactly what the Toyota pickup is all about. And when I say cheap, I mean cheap. You can regularly find these for under 1,500 bucks. Which is what truck guys spend on tires, let alone an entire truck. Now, if you need to haul things and haul people, you're probably thinking about getting a station wagon. And the maker of the most reliable, fun, and versatile wagons of all time is definitely Subaru. Now, while Subaru station wagons aren't exactly associated with speed, Subaru did make a name for itself on the international stage by kicking ass in rally racing. And they used that race-winning technology to bring to their streetcars. The Subaru Impreza proved that it was capable of taking serious punishment off-road. And that legacy, get it, legacy, continues on to this day, with the Impreza, Outback, and Legacy wagons being the gold standard in reliable station wagons today. You could roll any of these off the side of a cliff a couple of times and it would still run. Any of these old Subi wagons are equally reliable and all come with pretty much the same engines and that same awesome asymmetric all-wheel drive system that will help you conquer pretty much any dirt road you can drive down. And some of them can actually tow up to 2,700 pounds. So if you're looking for a reliable ride and you live in some rugged terrain, definitely get yourself a Subaru wagon for under $3,000, and you will not be disappointed. Now our next ride isn't exactly as fun as an all-wheel drive station wagon, but it is reliable. I'm talking about a car most people probably don't even remember, the Geo Metro. When General Motors set out to create the most fuel-efficient car possible without doing a lot of research and development, they created the Geo Metro. The mighty little Metro features one of the world's cutest little engines, either a minuscule 1.3 little four-cylinder or a hilariously small 1-liter three-cylinder that produces a whopping 70 horsepower, all tucked under a body that's practically made out of cardboard. Now that underpowered power plant is the secret to the Geo Metro's lasting success. With an engine making that little power, it basically never breaks down. With a little maintenance, that thing will outlast all of us and get 40 miles per gallon while doing it. This oversized toy car is guaranteed to save you a ton of money over its lifetime, but you get what you pay for with the Metro. There is no refined luxury inside the car and has only the very basic of safety features. There's only an airbag for the driver because, you know, you're driving Geo Metro, they know you're gonna be alone. Getting in a crash in one of these is basically like wearing a bicycle helmet. But if you manage to avoid an accident, this car will probably outlive you and your children. And for just 1,200 bucks, you could be the proud or not so proud owner of this Geo Metro. Now, a brand synonymous with safety is Volvo. The Swedes are the pioneers of protection. And probably the most iconic Volvo of all time is the Volvo 240. If you want to give an impression to others that you have a degree from an esteemed college or that you read philosophy books for fun, pulling up in an old Volvo 240 is definitely the way to do it. The appearance of this iconic car is synonymous with safety and responsibility. And despite how ratty and grungy they look, I kind of always assume the 1% are the people driving these. Now the Volvo 240 became so prolific thanks to Volvo's incredible safety features that they packed in. But today, it's famous for one reason: it just will not die. And luckily, they're pretty popular. So if you ever did need to replace anything in it, which I can pretty much guarantee you won't, parts are actually pretty cheap and easy to install. One major problem that these 240s did run into, however, is that their once classy exterior pretty quickly starts to degrade. Luckily, versions of the 240 made after 1988 offer far better corrosion resistance to models made earlier. Sadly, most of the world has caught on to the 240, so prices seem like they're going up. So you can pick up a good example today for just under $4,000, but just think of all the money you'll save not having to fix anything on it. Now, I bet you can guess what the next car on our list is, because it's always the answer. I don't like doing that. That's right, the Mazda Miata is actually an extremely reliable car, and it's definitely the most fun car on this list. There's a reason the Miata is always the answer. They're fun, they're fast, they're cute, there's tons of modifications, and they're reliable. And who can resist pop-up headlights? You know I can't. The Miata is not just a pretty face. It's an invincible little ball of energy with a dynamite transmission that'll have you zipping through traffic from the day you buy it till you're old and gray. Now, the 1.6 liter engine generates significantly less power than the 1.8 that followed it, but the upside is that underpowered engine will last forever. And with how lightweight the Miata is, there's not a lot of stress on the drivetrain keeping this thing running, so parts tend to last a really long time on these. The only problem is the temptation to put your foot on the gas and drive on a curvy road and tear this thing up, which will make it less reliable over time, but it sure is a hell of a lot more fun. Now, fortunately or unfortunately, prices on Miatas are actually going up, so it's rare but not impossible to find one for under $2,000. But the good news is if you take good care of it and keep the miles low, you might actually be able to sell it for twice that in a few years. So you see, not all cheap cars have the shelf life of a carton of milk, and not all reliable cars are as boring as a math class. So what did we get right? Which of these cars was your favorite? Let us know down below. Was it the swanky Lexus? Was it the drop-top Miata? Or was it that used cop car? It was the used cop car, right? I mean, that's what I want. No matter what you choose, make sure to subscribe to Ideal Media below and give us a like. And while you're at it, check out some more Ideal content. And no matter what you do, always keep living the ideal lifestyle.